Now, let us have introduction to some commonly used glassware in the laboratory. The most common glassware is volumetric flask. These are a volumetric flask or measuring flask or graduated flask. It is calibrated to contain a precise volume at a particular temperature. Volumetric flasks are used for precise dilution and preparation of standard solutions. It has a mark ring upon which we have to fill the flask. It has a stopper too. These are of variable capacity from 5 ml to 2 liter. Conical flasks. These are conical flasks or laboratory flasks which can be used for making solutions or for holding, containing, collecting, or sometimes volumetrically measuring chemicals, samples, solutions, etc. For chemical reactions or other purposes such as mixing, heating, cooling, dissolving, precipitation, boiling, as we do in distillation or other analysis. One common glassware is a beaker. These are beakers. It is a simple container for stirring, mixing, and heating liquids commonly used in many laboratories. Beakers are generally cylindrical in shape with a flat bottom. Most also have a small beak or spout to add pouring as shown. Beakers are available in a wide range of sizes from 10 milliliter up to several liters. Another glassware used in the laboratory are measuring cylinder or mixing cylinder. These are measuring cylinders or mixing cylinders. These are used to measure the volume of a liquid. Graduated cylinders are generally more accurate and precise than laboratory flasks and beakers. Funnels. These are funnels that have been made from use in the chemical laboratory. Wash bottle. Burette. Burette is a device used in analytical chemistry for the dispensing of variable measured amounts of chemical solution. A volumetric burette delivers measured volume of liquid. How to use a burette? To fill a burette, close the stopcock at the bottom and use a funnel. You may need to lift up on the funnel slightly to allow the solution to flow freely. Deliver solution to the titration flask by turning the stopcock. Hold the wall with left hand and with the help of your thumb. Middle finger and index finger can help you in rotating it carefully. Keep the white tile or white paper under the conical flask for clear and point display. The solution should be delivered quickly until a couple of milliliters from the end point. When reading a burette, it is important that your line of slide be in a direction perpendicular to the burette column. Look at the concave bottom of the meniscus, which is clearly outlined. Pipette. This is a pipette or chemical dropper. Is a laboratory tool commonly used in chemistry, biology, and medicine to transport a measured volume of liquid, often as a media dispenser. Pipettes come in several designs for various purposes, with different level of accuracy and precision. From single piece of glass pipette bulb pipettes, graduated pipettes, to more complex adjustable or electronic pipettes. Use of pipette. Insert the tip of pipette into the beaker of solution so that it is about 1/4 inch from the bottom. Be sure not to press the tip against the bottom of the container. If you are right-handed, hold the pipette in your right hand, leaving your index finger free to place over the top of pipette. With your left hand, squeeze the pipette bulb, press it firmly over the top of pipette, but do not insert the pipette into the bulb. Release the pressure on the bulb and allow the solution to flow into the pipette until it is above the volume mark. Do not allow the solution to reach the bulb. A stirring rod or stir rod or glass rod. It is used to mix chemicals and liquids for laboratory purposes. They are usually made of solid glass, about the thickness and slightly longer than a drinking straw, with rounded ends. Like most laboratory glass, stir rods are made up of borosilicates, commonly known as pyrex. Filter paper. This is filter paper used for filtration of solution. Tissue paper. This is tissue paper used for cleaning and drying off cuvettes and pipettes. While working in a laboratory, one should wear apron in order to protect our clothes from chemicals.
Use of thick hand gloves while working or washing or cleaning with acid is mandatory.
Cleaning of glassware before and after analysis work. Glassware should be neat and clean. If there is any dirt, then remove the dirt by simple washing or wash with detergent powder. If glassware cannot be cleaned by simple washing or use of detergent powder, we have to use 5% chromic acid solution to wash the glassware. Use of thick hand gloves while working or washing or cleaning with acid is mandatory. So these are certain important aspects which has to be keep in mind while working in laboratory.